Good afternoon, everyone. This is Xing Ru speaking. First and foremost, I would like to thank everyone for taking the time and effort to attend my wedding today. To my relatives and two brothers who have seen me grow up through the years, and not forgetting friends who have seen me through various stages of my life, I thank you. I am truly blessed to be surrounded with so much love and support. I would also like to take this opportunity to say a few words to just some of you who have made a difference in my life. This is my dad. Handsome, right? He has always been saying, "I inherited his good genes." You be the judge. Growing up, my dad is the prime example of the traditional Chinese father who does not express his love through words but actions instead. Need a ride regardless of the time of the day? He is just a phone call away. Too tired to do the laundry or household chores? He will do it for you without any words of complaint. Fail to perform academically in school? Doesn't matter to him so long as I have tried my best. Who through the many things that he does quietly and without complaint, showed me his unconditional love for the family. Thank you, Ba. This is my beautiful mother. She too has been saying that I inherited her good genes. You be the judge. Also, fun fact, my parents got married on this day exactly 39 years ago. This is a photo I managed to dig up from their photo albums. Anyway, growing up, my mom had to juggle raising three boys on top of a busy career. Admittedly, I never really understood how difficult it was until much later on in my life. She told a way to provide a better life for the family, and it affected her health, all for the sake of family. Thank you, Ma, for your sacrifices and for being the gel that keeps our family together. Lastly, I was lucky enough to have been looked after by both my paternal and maternal grandmothers. Both were excellent cooks, and I always look forward to their meals, especially during family gatherings. You know, they always say that there are just some homemade food that can never be replaced, and I must say, I miss the tu tuo teng cooked by my ama, and the shark's fin soup cooked by my waipo. Ama, waipo, wo gao yin liao. I know the both of you will be very happy for me today. To my new parents and brothers, thank you for welcoming me to your family with open arms. You have shown me the length all of you would go for your family, and the sacrifices you made has inspired me to endeavor to do likewise. Not to mention all the good food. Special shout out to the seafood. You feed me whenever I'm over for your meals. Thank you.
Hello everyone, this is Sharon. After close to 2 years, Xing Ru and I are finally having our banquet. Thank you to everyone for all your love and support and for making time to be here with us today. We really appreciate it. Now, let me take some time to thank the significant people in my life. Without them, I will not be who I am today. This is my father. My father is like a typical traditional man who isn't the best at expressing his feelings. As such, growing up, his poker face won him the title of being the disciplinarian of our home. Although he may be strict with us and may look fierce on the outside, he is in fact a softy within, or better explained with this Chinese phrase, zui ying xing ran. Being a man of few words, my father shows his love for us through his actions. He is always very willing to spend on us but will often stinge on himself. With three kids, travel was a luxury we could not afford often. But whenever we go travelling, my father will always give us a sum of money each to buy whatever we want, while he busy himself buying souvenirs back for friends and relatives, and nothing but memories for himself. Our fridge is also constantly filled with fresh fish and seafood every week when he visits the market with my mother. This is his way of loving us, by ensuring that we are always provided for and well fed. Thank you, Pa, for loving us in your own ways. And thank you for imparting to me the joy of giving and for teaching me the importance of generosity. Coco and I know that we don't say this often enough, but don't ever forget that we will always love you. This is my beloved mother. Anyone who knows me well would know that I'm close to my mother and have always been a mommy's girl. When I was young, I always fight with my brothers to sit next to my mother and would always pester her to bring me shopping. Look how fashionable she was last time. I guess we all know where I got my love from shopping from. Whenever we lose something at home, the first person we all go to for help would be my mother, and she will almost always stop whatever she's doing to help us look for it. She's ever selfless and accommodating to our requests, and I wish that I'll be able to be a fraction of who she is when I grow older. As years passed, our conversations and interaction methods have also slowly evolved. We're now able to poke fun at each other and hang out chasing dramas together. She's not only my mother, but a friend and gossip partner. Mummy, thank you for teaching me the true meaning of unconditional love and the importance of being positive, kind, and patient to the people around us. I love you and I'll always be your little girl. Now, say hello to the two other guardians in my life. These are my brothers. Many people used to envy me for having two elder brothers. I guess they all had the impression that elder brothers would always dote on the younger sister. Ha! For our case, my eldest brother was often busy with his own life as I was growing up due to our larger age gap. Other than that, we got on quite amicably. I can't say the same for my second brother and I though. We quarrelled, fought, and irritated each other on a daily basis. Like what my mom would say, both of us, 贴错门神. But if I was bullied outside, my brothers would not hesitate to stand up and protect me. I'm very thankful and proud to say that we have all grown up well and matured, and these are just anecdotes of our childhood. Thank you, Cops, for always being the bigger person by putting up with my nagging and being patient and tolerant towards me. Thank you, Shanikoko, for always being the humorous one and for your quiet support all these years. Most importantly, I'm super thankful that you married Grace. Thank you, Grace, for bringing so much fun and joy into our family and for being the big sister I always wanted growing up. I'm happy to announce that all of your sibling memberships will be auto-renewed with no refunds. Yay! Love you! I'd like to dedicate some time in remembrance of my late grandmothers who have brought me up. I'm very fortunate to have grown up with both my grandmothers around, whom I love dearly and miss to this day.
Ama, ning nang ji zong tao di ge. Ha ba. Wo de a gong liao ba. Ama, wo dua liao. Geng zhe gao ying liao. Le tai de ba. Wo jing xiao ning nan.
To all my relatives who have watched me grow up, thank you for all your care and love all these years. To all my friends and colleague-turned-friends, thank you for all your love and support. I cannot agree more to the sentence, friends are families we choose. So I just want to say,
사랑해, 친구야!
Lastly, thank you to my new family for accepting me with warm open arms. I look forward to creating memories and more joyous time together with all of you.